Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Ladies and gentlemen, may we introduce you our 12 finalists. Wearing streetwear by Harley Davidson and shoes by Aldo. This is the Miss Universe Singapore 2014 Spokesmodel Finals.
Ladies all across the world. And now, your host from Fly Entertainment, actor, radio DJ, Bobby Tonelli.
What a way to start a show. Welcome to Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Aren't these girls looking hot? Absolutely wearing the latest shoes by Aldo, streetwear by Harley Davidson. Thank you, ladies, very much. Thank you. Let's take some time to introduce our panel of judges, because it's up to them who will be deciding who will become Miss Universe Singapore 2014. First, we have Dr. Ronnie Yap. He's responsible for creating beautiful smiles from Orchard Scott's Dental. Yes, big round of applause. Next, we have Dr. Yuen Chi, medical director of the Chelsea Clinic. Ina Shapiro, representing Fashion TV. We have Jeremy Gah, who's not with us right now, but he is the general manager representing Komoko Holdings. Oh, there he is, right over there. Sorry about that, Jeremy. I was waiting for you to be right next to Ina. Next, we have Ramzan Minhat, managing director of Diamonds and Diamond sponsor for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Kelly Vaughn, Hollywood actress and producer of the Star World's Apartment. Priscilla Chan, MediaCorp artist, Star Award winner and actress, and Channel 8's The Voyage, A Journey. Mr. Errol Pong, national director of Miss Universe Singapore and managing director of Daryl Stephanie Promotions, also known as the King of Queens. Junita Simon, looking beautiful as ever, supermodel of the world, presenter, host, mother extraordinaire, wife extraordinaire. Here she is, one of our judges as well. And this man needs no introduction to Singapore. He is one of fashion's biggest icons here, fashion director, television host, and author of his new-to-be-released autobiography. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Daniel Boy. Now, all these judges have spent some time with these girls prior to this, over video shoots, photo challenges, interview sessions, and they've scored all these girls, but they've kept these scores a secret. They're gonna tabulate them along with what they see tonight to choose who will be the top five and who will also walk away with a crown. Now, they're looking for tonight's stage presence, elegance, poise, body figure, catwalk ability, the X factor, and most importantly, how they tackle the Q&A. These girls are very nervous over that one. You would think it'd be swimwear. No, they've got that handled. It's the questions and answers. We're gonna have some fun with that one later on. So without further ado, let's kick things off. Let's start it with the latest in resorts and swimwear collection by Inner Desire, shoes and accessories by Aldo. Here they are, your top 12 finalists for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. We'll be right back.
I spilled the ink across the page, trying to spell your name. So I fold it up and I flick it out, paper aeroplane. It won't fly the seven seas for you, cause it didn't leave my room. But it awaits the hands of someone else, garbage man. Gotta say,
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for your finalists in swimwear by Inner Desire. Thank you, ladies. By BCBG, Max Azria, exquisite fine jewelry by Diamonds, and shoes by Aldo. Here they are again, your top 12 spokesmodel finalists. Give it up to our 12 finalists this evening. Don't they look absolutely gorgeous? I'm gonna take a moment, not being a host and just being an observer. Wow. Tonight I love my job. Okay. Well, I wanna take this time to thank the people backstage who've worked tirelessly to make these women look even more beautiful than they already are. First, I'd like to thank our fashion stylist, Rian Hafiz, Cecilia Chung and her hair and makeup team from Vive Salon, styling team from Dada Glow, not forgetting the spectacular fine jewelry by Diamonds. Ladies and gentlemen, over $25 million is on stage right now. So with that, we're gonna take a short 10-minute break, let the judges tabulate their scores, have a quick bite to eat. We're gonna come back with your top five and a Q&A segment. We're back with you in a short bit. Thank you very much, ladies. Thank you. Surprise, I'm not one of the finalists. Nope. They asked me to go in swimwear, but it just didn't fit. But nonetheless, now I want to introduce you our 12 finalists, because from now we are gonna choose the top five based on the judges' scores. And then from there, we're gonna go to the Q&A. This is a very, very difficult decision to choose five of these girls. But you have made your choices, and I have coming on stage here, Mr. Ian, with the top five. And actually, Ian is wearing a kilt and nothing underneath, by the way, just in case you were wondering. Now, I am going to read out the top five in no particular order. The first name I'm going to call, Danielle Lin. The second name I'm going to call, Ijechi Nwatsutsu. Third name I'm going to call, Amisha Francis. The fourth name, Rati Menon. And now, for the last girl who will be entering the top five. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Arian North. These are your top five for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Wait a second though, wait a second. Ladies and gentlemen. While we're cheering for these top five, we have seven beautiful women back there who worked their butt off to get to this point. Can we all give them a big round of applause? And to give them a token of appreciation, the man who's been working tirelessly with these girls and presenting you the show that you're seeing right now, can I have on stage the choreographer, Mr. Rosli Kasim. Rosli, come on stage with me to present a token of appreciation to our seven remaining finalists. Here is our good-looking usher, Neil, with some bouquets. May I have the remaining girls come up in sequential order? Rosli, thank you very, very much. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, your top five for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. All right. Ladies, the moment a lot of you have not been waiting for, the question and answer segment. So now I'm going to have an assistant here, very beautiful Asha, is going to come on stage with five cards. Each of these cards have a judge's name on it. The contestant will choose the card and the judge will ask a question and they will answer it. Asha, you ready? Let's bring out first Amisha Francis. Amisha, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you, Bobby?
I'm doing fantastic. Are you feeling nervous?
I'm not. I'm feeling hopeful.
Fantastic. Okay, Amisha, pick a card. All right. The first question comes from Dr. Yuan Chi. Dr. Yuan, can you ask the question, please? We'll give you a microphone.
Hi, Amisha.
Hi, how are you?
What is Singapore's national dish, and how would you promote it?
For me, Singapore's national dish is anything from chili crab to Hainanese chicken rice. But essentially, I think it would be Peranakan food, because just something that would take all the elements, Malay, Chinese, Indian, bring it together. I think that would be a great national dish for Singapore. And I would promote it by saying that it was unique. It was a mix of cultures, which is what Singapore essentially is. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Misha. I got a question just to add on to Dr. Ewan's. You mentioned a dish, and there's a lot of foodies here in the audience, I'm sure, and they have a lot of favorite places to go. You mentioned Peranakan. Where is your favorite place to eat Peranakan food?
This is so easy. Go to my grandma's house. She is the best Peranakan cook.
All right. Thank you very much, Amisha. Thank you. Next, I'd like to invite Rati Menon. Rati, how are you?
Very excited.
I can imagine. Are you nervous? Well, there was a light. Are you nervous wearing that beautiful diamond necklace around you? Because that looks like a lot of money.
Not at all. It's making me more beautiful, in fact.
I think people would agree. All right, Rati, pick a card. All right, the next question comes from Priscilla Chan.
Hi, Hi, beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay, mine is not easier. Describe the worst scenario if the world is deprived of internet and mobile services one day.
Thank you for the question. Yep. Good evening, everyone. I think the worst case scenario when we are deprived of internet and mobile services is to lose the connection with loved ones, because it's these services that enable us to connect with our loved ones near or far. So not knowing where they are or if they're in danger, I think that will be the worst scenario. Thank you.
Very well said.
All right. Now, Rati, what's the longest you've gone without internet or a mobile phone or anything like that?
The longest I've gone was a week.
A week?
Yes.
Where were you at?
Back in secondary school when I didn't pay my bill, so it got cut off and yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Rati. Thank you. Got to pay the bills. You have to pay those. Next, let's invite up Miss Arian North. Arian, how are you?
Hello, Bobby, I'm fine.
Great, great. Arian, pick a card, please. This question comes from Ramzan Minhat from Diamonds Jewelry.
Hello, Yoyo.
Hello.
You look lovely anyway.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, my question is increasing the Singapore population to 7 million a good move?
Wow.
Wow, that's a tough question.
Very political, yeah?
Well, I would say it is a good move because Singapore, we used to be a really tiny island and we built more reclaimed land, and I don't see why we can't have more reclaimed land and bring more people in.
Right.
Thank you for the question.
Okay. So, Arian, there's a lot of people that are unhappy with the growth in population. Yeah. What would you say to them?
I mean, we're all humans. I think we should love people and let them in if we want to.
Fair enough. All right, Arian, thank you very, very much. Next, Ijechi Nwautuzu. Ijechi, how are you?
I am good, thank you. How are you?
I'm great. I'm looking at you like, wow, you look fantastic, by the way.
Thank you.
I try.
You're trying very well, by the way. Pick a card, Ijechi. This question comes from Dr. Ronnie Yap.
Hello.
Hello.
Congratulations on being the top five.
Thank you.
If you don't win the title, would you consider joining the competition again? Why or why not?
Thank you for the question. If I don't win the title, my answer would be no, I would not join the competition again. And I say this because the past few months has been an amazing journey. I felt like I've learned a lot and I've grown as a person, which was one of the main reasons why I wanted to join this competition. So if I don't win the title, instead of joining again, I would rather use that experience and that newfound knowledge to pursue other activities and do something that is bigger and something that is beyond myself. So, thank you.
Very good answer. Ijechi, what is the one thing that you've learned from this competition so far that you will take for the rest of your life?
Wow. Out of all the things, I would say that confidence is really important. I've always grown up, I guess, thinking that confidence is something that you either have or you don't. But this competition has taught me that it's something you can work on. It's something everybody can work on. And every one of us has it inside us to be someone greater than what we are at the moment. So.
All right.
Thank you.
Ejechi, thank you very much. And I think the audience agrees. And now for our final contestant here, the top five, Ms. Danielle Lim. Danielle, how are you?
I am doing great.
How are you feeling right now?
I am a little nervous, to be honest, but you know, I'm just gonna go and do my very best.
That's all we're asking for today, and you have done fantastic so far. Danielle, pick a card. All right. This question, final question, comes from our managing director of Daryl Stepney Promotions, Mr. Errol Pong.
Hi, Danielle.
Hello.
Congratulations for being in the top five.
Thank you very much.
Are you nervous?
Okay, getting a bit bolder in a minute.
I'm going to ask you a very difficult question.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Many have said that in order to win international titles, Singapore must give citizenships to beautiful foreigners to represent us, just like in table tennis, badminton, swimming, and athletics. What do you think? Should we?
Hey, thank you for that question. Singapore is a very young nation, and with foreign talent has aided us to grow greater in the international scene. But I believe that as the nation progresses, more Singaporeans, homebred Singaporeans, will rise up to the challenge and be the forerunner in the international scene. And I believe that the Daryl Stepney Promotions and the crew has been steadily pushing and increasing the quality of girls each year. And in a matter of time, it's just in a matter of time, someone will win in the international scene. Thank you.
Wow. You know, politics could be in your future. Let me ask you this. There is a lot of foreign talent that's coming to Singapore. But what is one thing you think foreign talent should learn about Singaporeans?
Well, I think it's Singlish because it's uniquely Singapore.
Can. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Our top five finalists. Now our judges are writing profusely on their paper to try to tabulate the scores, and we will come back with you in a short bit. But first, we have a performance by a renowned Cirque performer, Michael Bellamin, will entertain you right now. Thank you, ladies. Now, the subsidiary awards each of these girls are eligible for. I'd like to invite up on stage first, Mr. Douglas Gunn, co-founder of Vanity Trove, to present the Miss Vanity Trove Award. We're gonna give away some awards here. Our first award, let's say the criteria is the girl with the most number of likes of their posts, the number of followers, the number of posts made on vanitytrove.com.sg. And the winning prize is a $1,000 cash prize, trophy, sash, and bouquet. Douglas, how are you? Okay, we're back on track. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner is Miss Stella Kay. We're going to present Scylla with a sash and bouquet, an award, and you'll receive the money later. Photo opportunity, please. Thank you very much. Thank you, Douglas. Next, we have Miss City of Dreams. This is sponsored by Melco Crown Entertainment, preferred resorts destination. We'd like to invite up on stage Mr. Kelvin Tan, Executive Vice President, International Marketing of Melco Crown Entertainment. Now, the criteria for this, a girl who is eloquent yet possesses a vibrant and fun personality, and she's gonna walk away with a 2-night accommodation at Crown Tower City of Dreams Macau, plus 2 VIP tickets to to the House of Dancing Water Show, plus $300 cash prize, trophy, sash, and bouquet. And the winner is Miss Erin North. Thank you very much. Thank you. Next, we have Miss Brilliance Award. This is brought to you by Diamonds, our official fine jewelry. Now, the criteria is a girl who possesses the physical quality of magnificence, splendor, grandeur, and radiance. She must also have exceptional clarity in the intellectual conversation she carries. I would like to invite on stage Yasin Kafi, Chief Operating Officer of Diamonds, to present this award, along with Neil, our bouquet holder. And the winner for Miss Brilliance is Rati Menon. She's gonna walk away with a 2.6 carat princess cut diamond earrings valued over $20,000, plus $300 cash prize, trophy, sash, and bouquet. Rati, you are gonna shine bright like a diamond, literally. Next we have Miss Body Beautiful. I think the title says it all, right? Brought to you by Komoko Motors Private Limited. I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Jeremy Ga, General Manager representing Komoko Holdings. Now, Jeremy, what's the criteria for this one?
It's a tough question, man. Well, basically, Miss Body Beautiful, that's what it says. She's got to have a beautiful body.
And a lot of these girls have beautiful bodies tonight, don't they?
That's right. It's so tough.
Very, very tough. Only one can win this, and she's going to walk away with a $300 cash prize, trophy, sash, and bouquet. And the winner is Miss Arian North. It pays to work out, right? It really does. A photo opportunity, please. Thank you, Arian. Jeremy, just hang out with me on stage one more time because we're giving out Miss Personality. Now, this is sponsored by Harley Davidson of Singapore, our official streetwear. The criteria is a girl who is independent, has a cool attitude, a sense of individualism, chic and confident. This girl is going to walk away with a $300 cash prize, trophy, sash, and bouquet. The winner is Miss Rati Menon. And here's Neil back on stage with more bouquets, sashes, and trophies for you. Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, Rati, move on. We'll have a photo later on. Thank you very much. Thanks, Jeremy. Next, moving on to Miss Sensational Smile. We're looking for a woman who brushes her teeth. I'm joking. Award giver will be Dr. Ronnie Yap from Orchard Scotts Dental. Dr. Yap, come on stage. Now, the criteria for this is obviously straight, white teeth, healthy gums, and a wide, even smile. And the prize is actually very good. A 1 year worth of beauty white package valued at $1,200 plus $300 cash prize plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. And the winner for Miss Sensational Smile is Jana Kamalaludin. Always pays to floss and brush. Thank you, Dr. Yap. Now moving on to Miss Photogenic. This is brought to you by the Chelsea Clinic. I'd like to invite on stage Dr. Yuan Chi, medical director of the Chelsea Clinic. And we're looking for the girl with the most photogenic appeal. On-camera chemistry, warmth, personality, and of course, great skin. And the winner's gonna walk away with a $300 cash prize plus $200 worth of Derma Solutions products plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. The winner for Miss Photogenic is Krista Beltois. Photo opportunity, please. All right. Moving on to Miss Best Skin. Brought to you by Data Lux. I'd like to invite on stage Jason Pagliaro, Executive Director of Data Lux Private Limited. Now, the criteria, obviously, for best skin is good skin, right? Even skin tone with no blemishes, skin suppleness, overall smoothness, and a glow of the body and face. This prize is gonna be a $300 cash prize, plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. And the winner, once again, is Miss Krista Beltois. I must ask her what her skin regime is. She must exfoliate. Wait, we have a selfie. And let's have a photograph here. Thank you very much. Next we have Miss Best Catwalk. Now I'd like to invite on stage Mr. R. Dinakaran, Managing Director of Montreal Private Limited, franchisee of Aldo Shoes and Accessories. The criteria is stage confidence, catwalk skills, and body posture. The prize is a $300 cash prize, plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. The winner for Miss Best Catwalk is Arian North. I think she needs a basket. Thank you very much. Thank you. Moving on to Miss Best Legs. It says it itself. Criteria is you gotta have really good legs. I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Errol Pong, Managing Director of Daryl Stephanie Promotions and Organizing Chairman of Miss Universe Singapore. The prize will be a $300 cash prize plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. Is Mr. Pong here with us? Yes, he is. Hi, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
So, giving out Miss Best Legs. They all have very good legs tonight, I have to say. Only one can win, and the winner is Ijechi Nwatsotsu. Thank you, Mr. Pong, thank you. And our final subsidiary award is Miss Most Outstanding Model. Brought to you by Daryl Stephanie Promotions, I'd like to invite on stage Miss Penelope P., Managing Director of Warner Artists and Director of Daryl Stephanie Promotions for Miss Universe Singapore. Penelope. So the criteria for this is the girl who's approachable, outgoing, committed, motivated, spreads goodwill, and has shown outstanding improvements. She's gonna walk away with a $300 cash prize plus trophy, sash, and bouquet. And the winner is Penelope. You want to read out the name?
And the winner is Haymisha Francis.
Haymisha. Much Penelope. And now the moment a lot of you have been waiting for, to announce our runners up and to crown Miss Universe Singapore 2014. So I'm gonna look for Ian, the very good looking gentleman in a kilt, to come on stage with the names. All right, ladies and gentlemen, your fourth runner-up for Miss Universe Singapore 2014 goes to Miss Danielle Lin. Your third runner-up for Miss Universe Singapore 2014 is Haymisha Francis. Your third runner-up for Miss Universe Singapore 2014 is Ijechi Niwatsutsu. All right, may I have the last two girls come on front. Erin, how do you feel right now?
Excited. Nervous a little bit.
Rati, how do you feel?
I'm just too excited.
You are, I can imagine so. Now, this is a very, very tough decision. I know the judges were deliberating quite a bit for this. Before I do announce the winner, I would like to take this time to invite on stage our Miss Universe Singapore 2013, Miss Shi Lim, to have her final walk. Shi has represented Singapore beautifully this past year as Miss Universe Singapore 2013. I'm sure she has a lot of exciting endeavors ahead of her. And she will take these memories with her for the rest of her life. Come over here with me a second. How does it feel being Miss Universe Singapore?
How does it feel? I think ultimately it's a lot about overcoming yourself. I think that's the greatest challenge, conquering yourself and feeling nervous every single day, but having to get over that. So even now, yeah, you never really get over it.
No. So what advice would you give to these two girls standing next to you?
Well, girls, no matter what happens, and this is for every girl here tonight, there can only be one Miss Universe Singapore, but never forget that each of you are beautiful and worthy in your own right. So you girls did amazing tonight. I'm so proud of you. Stay true to yourself.
Thank you very much, Shu. Hang on with me a second here. Now, we have two of these girls here. A disclaimer, of course. If for some reason the crowned winner of Miss Universe Singapore is unable to fulfill her duties, the runner-up will be taking her place. Just have to put that out there. Now I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Errol Pong, Managing Director of Stephanie Promotions, to help and assist me with announcing the winner for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Mr. Pong. Is that working yet? Okay, we'll get on that in a second. But first, Mr. Pong, I would like to announce what the winner will walk away with in terms of prizes and gifts, which is astounding. First, we have a $5,000 cash prize plus return airfare and accommodation to International Miss Universe pageant worth $5,000 plus crown and trophy. 4 carats, princess cut diamond earrings valued over $30,000, plus store voucher worth $5,000 by Diamonds. Smile Makeover, valued up to $15,000 by Orchard Scott's Dental. 2 nights accommodation at Crown Tower, City of Dreams, Manila, brought to you by Melco Crown Entertainment. Treatments worth $1,000 by the Chelsea Clinic. Hyundai Genesis car, chauffeured service, by the way, brought to you by Comoco Motors. Cash voucher worth $500 from Data Lux products, plus Numi tea gift set worth $128, plus Data Aroma diffuser worth $198, brought to you by Data Lux. Private makeup tutorial worth $500 by celebrity stylist Cecilia Chung from Vive Salon. Store voucher worth $600. 1 pair of Aldo shoes plus exclusive Aldo membership, brought to you by Aldo Shoes and Accessories. Evening gown worth $600, brought to you by BCBG Max Azaria. Bikini gift pack worth $80 plus $40 gift voucher by Inner Desire. I need a drink. Exquisite floral bouquet by Cocoon Divine. Exclusive feature and cover in Aesthetics and Beauty magazine by Aesthetics and Beauty. And complete model portfolio by New Story Boards. Wow, thank gosh you're not getting all these prizes on the stage at one go. So, the moment we've been waiting for. Mr. Pong, will you come next to me real quick?
Yep.
You got it?
I got it.
Okay, can we have the girls front and center? Mr. Pong, will you do the honors to announce the winner for Miss Universe Singapore 2014?
My pleasure, thank you. And Universe Singapore 2014 is Ruthie Menon.
And that means Miss Ari North is our runner-up for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. Just hold it on, it's okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the victory walk for Miss Universe Singapore 2014, who will continue on to the International Miss Universe in December. After you receive your bouquet and sash, I want to chat with you for a minute. She asked if there was another question and answer. No, you've completed the question and answers. But I want to talk to you for a second. How does this feel, this moment in your life?
It's an amazing feeling, and I feel like all my hard work paid off. Yes.
It definitely did. What was the hardest thing for you throughout this competition?
It has to be the catwalk, because I didn't have any prior experience, and I literally went under the block to practice my catwalk.
Well, you certainly rocked it tonight. You definitely did. Rati, enjoy this moment, and best of luck in December at the International Miss Universe. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Miss Universe Singapore 2014, Rati Menon. And a big round of applause to all these girls this evening who worked tirelessly over the past months to get to where they are today. I'd like to thank our panel of judges. Thank you guys so much for all your hard work. All our contestants, our sound and lighting crew by BizTech Systems, the entire production crew, by especially our choreographer, Rosli Kasim, L. Patterson, Roger Tam, Majesh Rajakopal, fashion stylist Rian Hafiz, DJ Alex Helm, Ian James Laird, our gentleman in the kilt, to all the backstage crew and helpers, to everyone, especially Penelope P, everyone at Daryl Stephanie Promotions. Thank you guys so much, and thank you all for joining us here for Miss Universe Singapore 2014. My name is Bobby Tinelli. Have a great night. Ladies and gentlemen, immediate family may come on stage for photo opportunities with our contestants and our winner. Once again, immediate family may come on stage.